Okay, forget pools, panic rooms and security cameras. They are surging in popularity across Queensland. Homeowners resorting to desperate measures to protect their properties.
Yeah, it's all on in Queensland. Let's bring in security guard Wayne Henker in the Gold Coast and homeowner Angelo Justice on the Sunshine Coast. Morning, guys. Nice to see you. First up for you, Wayne. It's on the Goldie over the weekend. Still massive problems with crime. What sort of security measures are we seeing surge?
Okay, so the measures that are about now are people are investing in security cameras and alarm monitorings, either high-end equipment or going to your local electronics store and getting some self kits that you can install yourself.
Some of the high-end stuff is obviously pretty expensive. What are some of the affordable measures out there that can really help to keep your property safe?
Okay, you can go to the electronics store and you can get systems that are, you know, up to about $1,000, you know, a third of the price, and you can take them home, plug them into your modem and set them up around your house in an hour or so and you're up and running. And these cameras are really fantastic, you know, the quality in that and in the footage is amazing, really. You can be anywhere in the world and you can be watching your home.
I reckon that my tip is, I've just done it myself, but to get the solar panels on them too, so that they charge themselves, so you're not going around charging them all the time. The other thing is, a lot of these crooks now, especially these young offenders, they're fully aware of the cameras. So what in addition to the cameras can you have?
Well, they've got audio on them now. So someone walks onto your property and they get a audio message saying that they are being watched and alarms actually sounding at them. So that's deterring them quite a lot.
Okay, let's bring in Angelo now. You were the victim, of course, of a violent carjacking at your property just 2 months ago. Have you increased your home security since then, Angelo?
Yeah, absolutely. I've set up multiple layer of security system at my place. I've installed a high-end, you know, video camera which got the deterrent, you know, alarms when people walks into your property. You know, it needs to be armed and disarmed, so there is a chance that we could forget one day. So I've got a second layer of Ring camera set up where it chimes inside the house as well as sends you a notification on your phone. And if that, you know, if they get past that, I got smart locks installed whereby, you know, if someone tries to open the door, it will send me a reminder. Then if they fail that, if that fails and they come into the house, and I got an alarm system armed whenever we are not at home to go off immediately as well. So, you know, because of what happened to us, we've increased our security system big times at our homes. Plus, you know, with the car, we've made sure that there is a car tracker in all of our cars. And plus, we've made sure that the steering lock is also, you know, manual steering lock is also installed.
You full court pressed it. Do you feel safer?
Sadly, I have to say, I don't feel safer. To be honest with you, with what happened to us, these measures that we have put in place now wouldn't have stopped. You know, they're so brazen with arms, and I was in the car. It wouldn't have stopped them doing that crime to us. So, unfortunately, despite some deterrence, I don't see this to be the answer.
Gee,
that's a worry, isn't it? I know a lot of people in Queensland who've upped their security and feel exactly the same way. There's a victims group marching on Parliament House later in the week to really make their voices heard as well, because it is a problem that is not going anywhere. Wayne and Angelo, we appreciate your time this morning. Thanks for joining us.